to give the citation of the only female honoree. So may I respect you? Dame Winifred Akpani is a seasoned chartered accountant and an accomplished business executive who is the founder and chief executive officer of Northwest Petroleum and Gas Company Limited. This is an indigenous petroleum products marketing company, and she is a director of several other businesses. She's a thorough professional who is driven by integrity, ambition, hard work, and excellence. Her primary goal in life is to achieve the very best in whatever she sets out to do. Dame Winifred Akpani holds a BSc degree in mathematics. You see, mathematics is not for everybody. Top degree in mathematics, you have to have it here, which she does have in large quantities. She holds a BSc degree in mathematics, second class upper division from the University of Benin, and a postgraduate diploma in computer science from the University of Lagos. Both the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria, FCA, and also a fellow of the Institute of Directors. She has attended numerous local and international courses and seminars cutting across finance, oil and gas, corporate governance, and banking. You see, her husband is a banker. She's in oil. They merge very well, doesn't it? Those are the only two industries that are, you know, flourishing in Nigeria now, aren't they? Dame Winifred Akpani has over 30 years post-graduation work experience, starting in 1987 as a trainee accountant with Ernst & Young. Thereafter, she moved to Arthur Andersen & Co., now KPMG, Professional Services, where she qualified as a chartered accountant in 1990. Leaving the practice there in 1992 as an audit senior, she joined Flame Petroleum and Gas Company Limited, a startup oil marketing company, as financial controller, and rose to the position of executive director within 5 years. Shows you what stuff she's made of. In her quest for self-fulfillment, she left the company in 1998 to found her own company, Northwest Petroleum and Gas Company, and assumed the position of Managing Director, Chief Executive Officer. We cannot talk about Dame Winifred Akpani without talking about Northwest Petroleum. Northwest Petroleum and Gas Company Limited is an indigenous oil and gas trading company with international repute. The company has vast experience in the importation, supply, distribution, and storage of petroleum products, and is also actively involved in the official export of crude oil from Nigeria, being one of the companies approved by the NNPC for the allocation and export of Nigerian crude oil. The company has grown from a 200,000 Naira capital base startup supplying diesel to banks, homes, and guest houses to an international oil trading and services company with annual turnover in hundreds of millions of dollars. The company has investments in midstream and upstream sectors of the oil and gas industry. Among other facilities, facilities. Northwestern Oil and Gas operates two ultra-modern mega petroleum product storage terminals with combined capacity of 96.8 million liters, certified and licensed by the Department of Petroleum Resources. And they also have an ultra-modern berthing facility with international state-of-the-art firefighting and safety equipment. I joined one of the best in Nigeria. All these are strategically located in the Calabar Free Trade Zone, Cross River State. The company also owns and operates several unique 24 and 26 nozzle ultra-modern mega filling stations across the country under a very rapidly growing program. As Managing Director, Chief Executive Officer, Akpani is responsible for managing and directing all company affairs and activities with a framework determined by the company's mission statement and strategic corporate plans. She's also responsible for the provision of quality assurance and control in all projects in order that the objectives of Northwest Petroleum and Gas Company Limited are realized in a timely and cost-effective way. Akpani's commitment to humanitarian services is depicted in the company's corporate social responsibility to its host communities and the nation at large. The record in this area is unassailable. The company renders immeasurable support to the Nigerian Police Force, professional bodies, and several not-for-profit organizations in the country with emphasis on child care, health care, education, and security across the country. In the year 2009, it is the highest medal that can be awarded to the laity by the Pope. Akpani is a quiet philanthropist. She doesn't give and make loud noise. She gives quietly and she's off. You will never know. That is how she is.
And we know today.
I know, and people who know her know. The contribution she has made to the Augustine University in Ilara, Ilara and Ekpe, is well known. And it is because of her love for education and what she has done for education that she's been honored here today. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you a woman of substance, a woman philanthropist, a quiet giver, Dame Winifred Akpani.
Receive our honor. Did you notice that, any of you? Did you notice anything? Okay, be very vigilant in future. Now she is the one we are honoring. The husband was sitting that way. He was invited to join her and he stood out of respect behind because she is the lady we are honoring. The lady refused, urging him to come by her side. That is something for you to do, my guys. Because I know you are aspiring to take places of men in this country. These are some of the things you must learn. When you get there, and I know you get hired, you must respect your, that's the order of God. You must respect your man. Thank you. Now, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, time is fast spent. As we said before, it's out of distinction. Recognition of your contribution to education and impeccable pedigree that Awokoya Foundation put in field to honor you with this award. Heartiest congratulations, and to the man who stands by her all the time. You say a successful woman, I must be a very responsible gentleman.
Thank you.
distinguished ladies and gentlemen, I thank you very much for coming here today. And I thank, in a very, very special way, the SO Awokoya Foundation. Like the last awardee said, he wondered why he was being given an award. The few awards I've received, I've stopped wondering, because I've never gotten a real satisfactory response. So you've done this, you've done that, but quite frankly, I've never felt deserving of any award. My most prized award, of course, is the award by Pope Benedict XVI. And when I got the call that day, I burst out laughing because I thought someone was just playing a joke, you know. The cardinal called me and said, "Oh, you've been given a papal award." And I started laughing. I said, even if it's from the back, how will it get to me? And he was angry. He said, "What do you mean?" So I'm sorry, Your Eminence, but I didn't know what qualified me to be given a papal award. When my husband spoke to me about this award, I said to him, with all due respect, I didn't really know about the foundation. And I said, "What did I do again? You know, what is it for?" And then he said, "You know, I think you should take time to find out." And thank God for the internet. It's easy to find out anything you want to find out. But after I went through, I was very deeply honored. A man of many firsts, first chemistry graduate, so many firsts. And I asked him again, "So where did they find me from, you know?" And he said, "Don't worry, you know, accept if you will." I said, "Certainly." On the average, because of the work I do, every week, I think you get nothing less than 2-3 letters of nominations where you've been nominated for this award. And of course, we have a big file, we'll just put them there, because we know most of that is about money, it's not about anything. But I'm so impressed with this foundation, looking at what they have done. And in my company, we do more of primary education, because where we operate in Cross River State happens to be, you know, it's a bit of a kind of needy state. And one of the first things we did when we got there was to pick up a primary school. And I said to my people, "Go out and look for a school we could adopt." And they brought, at the end of the day, they brought three options. And when I picked the worst of the schools, nobody could understand. I said, "Well, it's better to take the worst so you at least know what you're doing, you know." And we picked this school where the first time I went, it was heartbreaking. Each classroom had four classes. You had, you know, one teacher and her children in one corner. So you can imagine a classroom not this big. You have one set, 20 children, 20, 20, 20, and then when it's raining, the children have to huddle because the roofs are leaking. Okay. And for me, I thought that would be worth doing. And I'm happy that today, so many years later, that school that started with maybe under 200 children, we had to peg at 1,002. I said to the governor, "If you take one more child beyond this 1,002, we're going to hands off," because we couldn't cope. Because suddenly, a local school, everybody wanted to put their children there because we had to provide facilities, we had to work on the teachers and all that. But why I'm saying this is that education is really quite fulfilling. And there's nothing like children that ordinarily may not have had a chance of going to school. You know, and then again, being a village school, you have to put some incentives, we have to give them food to make sure that they always look forward to going to school. And children have never heard about doing a national common entrance. I'm happy that at least today we have a lot of children that have gone to community schools. We look forward to when at least we will get to the higher level. So for me, this is very, very exciting, because even though we're doing primary education, we get a lot of people who want help with higher education. At least now we know we can send them to this foundation and support them there, because we really can take on primary, secondary, everything. So for us, this is very good. And the last two awardees said they're retired. Well, I'm not retired, and I'm not tired. But you know, when you are retired, it means that you have so much sorted away to a large extent. So we are still working, and we might not have so much sorted away. We're looking at. you know, we may not have, but because we are working, we're going to continue to support. When I was coming, I asked them. They didn't ask us for money, which is not very usual. You know, sometimes they'll say, bring something. But I was happy when I saw the envelope, you know. And I said, but again, you don't need them to ask you for money. You know that it's a foundation. No matter how much money they have, whatever you give will help. So yes, I did come with a token, okay? I didn't know the extent. Now I think I know better. So even though I've come with a token check, but I assure you that every year we will do something. I'll try to do what we need at least. And, you know, you can't imagine my joy seeing six girls. I won't have. One day, actually, I tend to like boys more than girls. And then one day, my husband said, I said to him, why do you always prefer girls? He said, because they take care of you. So look at my whole life. And I was quite touched. My mother, my sister, you, my wife, you know. Look at, you know, these boys, they never care about anybody. The girls will always, you know. And I said, okay, you have a wife. So, but I think again, part of why we have a lot of girls now is that the men start too early to look for money. And that's my experience as an employer. Okay, if you have one solid female employee, in my experience, with all due respect, and I know I have my top female manager here, and I say this, she's worth sometimes three female employees. They don't go anywhere. Before your female employees will leave, there has to be a strong cogent reason. But with the men, though, in my company, we have more or less 99% staff retention. We don't have those problems. But with the men, people can only lure them. But with the women, when they are dedicated, they are dedicated. So, I'm so glad that this woman has been here. Once again, I know the time is past, but the chairman is telling me so. Thank you very much. Thank you to the foundation. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.